All right, if you're using Google Sheets and you're getting the num error, we're going to go over several different ways in which that could happen. And we're going to talk about why it's happening in each circumstance and how to fix it. So the first way in which it can happen is kind of an easy mathematical example. If you remember middle school, high school, whenever you learned it, it's we're taking the square root of the numbers in this column. So if I double click in C6, we're using the square root function, and we're just doing the square root of 144 in this circumstance. So that all works fine until you get down to row 9 and you're trying to take the square root of negative 4. So you can't do that. And this error message is saying the square root function, the value is negative, so it has to be positive or 0. So if you still want to take the square root, let's say, of positive 4, what you could do is you could come in here and you could just use the absolute value function. So square root of the absolute value of B9 and hit enter, and then it works. So you either need to change the value to a positive or use the absolute value in that circumstance. All right, so another way in which you can get the number error, so let's slide down. So let's keep in mind as we're looking at this is that the number error is an error in the actual output of the function. So it's not saying that the function itself is wrong, and it's not having a problem with the cell that it's looking for. I'm just moving this down. It's an actual problem with the output. So saying, hey, look, I can do this math, but the result doesn't make sense. So in this case that I've laid out here is that we're taking the numbers in column B, and we're taking them to the power of the number in column C. So if I look at this formula, it's B30 to the power of C30. So that results in a giant number, and Google Sheets just throws his hands up and says, I don't do that kind of math, guys. That number's too big, so I'm just going to give you the number error. If you float in it, it says the numeric value is greater than, and that's some crazy number, and that's its limit, and it's past that. The other way that you can get a hint, when you're actually constructing this formula, you see the red line on the bottom of it, and you get the error message pop up before you even hit enter. So let me hover over it again. There, it's telling you the numeric value is greater than. Now, you won't see that until you get to the point in the formula where it knows it's an error. So if I backspace, get rid of the zero, it doesn't know that this is wrong yet until you hit the zero to make it a C30. But then it does give you that hint. So in theory, you don't even have to hit enter and see the pound num error. You can, if you're really paying attention, see that black pop up with the white text and fix it before it happens. So in this case, though, you really can't fix these, right? I mean, if you were trying to do that math, you're just going to have to find another way to do it. Let's move on to the last example. So if you want access to the spreadsheet that has all of the errors in it, and it has added notes to it, and even the error message that's not a specific type, so there's some information about that, follow the link in the description or the link that's on your screen right now, and you can get access to it. And if you go to File, Make a Copy, you can copy it into your Google Drive and reference it whenever you run into one of these errors. We have a finance function here called the internal rate of return. And what it's doing is it's figuring out, so look, if you put down $5,408 in the first year, and then in the subsequent years, you receive these cash inflows. So you had a cash outflow, $5,408, you bought an investment, and then you got these payments back. The internal rate of return that it calculates is 13%. But the way in which this formula is computed, if you accidentally have the cash outflow as a positive, so saying that someone paid you for an investment, you didn't pay them, let's do that, which would be a mistake in this circumstance because that doesn't make sense for this analysis. If you hit enter, then you get the pound num error. All right, and if we look at that error, it says the values must have a positive and a negative. So all of these are giving you error messages that are pretty helpful. They're kind of leading you to the conclusion. And I think if we use those three examples, you can see most of the time that you get pound number error, it's usually something like this. All right, so if you're getting the pound value error, we're going to look at how to fix that next.